Thank you for joining me today at Tantrum House Studio D. I'm Melissa Delp. Have you ever wanted to run your own dinosaur theme park? Well, now you can, because we're going to walk through how to play Dinosaur World. Is a tile-laying action selection worker activation game for 2 to 4 players that plays in about 1 to 2 hours. It's designed by Brian Lewis, David McGregor, and Marissa Masura, and it's coming to Kickstarter from Pandasaurus Games, who sponsored this video. This is a prototype copy, so some of the design, components, and terminology may change. In Dinosaur World, you're trying to build the most exciting, innovative, and lucrative park you can. Safety also matters, but when you're dealing with dinosaurs, some casualties are inevitable. At the end of the game, the player with the most victory points wins. So let's start with setup. Set up the 3 central island boards in the middle of the table. On the attraction island, place the attraction tiles face up in 4 stacks by type: security, food, merchandise, and ride. On the special building island, create a face-down stack of special building tiles with the A tiles on top, then the B tiles, and then the C tiles. Place 1 tile on each space. On the Dino Paddock island, place the shuffled stack of Dino Paddock tiles in its spot and place 1 tile on each space. Set up the public notice board near the other boards. Place the round marker on space 1. Randomly choose a start player and set turn order clockwise around the table. Place player markers on the 0 spots on the excitement and victory point tracks. Determine the objectives for the game by randomly choosing 3 objective cards, one from cards A, B, and C. Place them face up on the table. Shuffle the worker database cards and place them face down on the table. Place the 9 DNA dice in the bag and create general supply piles for these components: workers, dino meeples, coins, death tokens, excess security, threat and victory point tokens, and dino attack dice. Now you're ready to do the player setup. Each player takes a lab board and places their colored resource markers on these spaces. Space 2 for the basic DNA types, yellow, red, and blue. Space 1 for the advanced DNA types, green, purple, orange. Space 0 for the threat, security, and Jeep upgrade tracks. Then each player chooses one of their Jeep bonus tokens to place in the first slot of the Jeep upgrade track and immediately gains that bonus. Place the remaining Jeep bonus tokens, boredom tokens, and objective markers near the player boards. Each player also takes a park board, places a welcome center in the middle of the slot, and places their Jeeple on that tile. Each player will also draft a Dino Paddock tile and a special building tile. For the draft, draw and place face up a number of Dino Paddock tiles and special building tiles labeled A equal to the number of players plus 1. In turn order, players choose 1 tile, either a paddock or a building. Then in reverse order, players choose the opposite type of tile. The remaining tiles are placed on top of the correct draw stack. For beginning players, you can use predetermined start tiles instead of drafting tiles. These are listed in the rulebook. To complete setup, give players their starting coins based on turn order. 8 coins for the first player, 9 for second, 10 for third, and 11 for fourth. Now you're ready to learn how the game plays. In Dinosaur World, there are 5 rounds, and each round has 5 phases: hire workers, public actions, private actions, Jeep tour, and then income and cleanup. Some of these phases are played in turn order, and some are simultaneous. Let's start with the hire workers phase. You need scientists, administrators, park rangers, security, and other workers to help run your park, and to take actions in the next few phases. Reveal worker database cards equal to the number of players plus one. In turn order, each player selects one of the cards and takes the matching worker meeples. Then discard all the revealed worker database cards. When the deck runs out, shuffle the discard pile. Now it's time to move to the public actions phase. There is some setup at the beginning of this phase. Draw a number of DNA dice from the bag equal to the number of players plus two and roll them. Place these dice in the spaces under the Gather DNA action. During this phase, you'll take actions in turn order on the three central boards until all players pass. On the special building island, you can buy a tile by spending one worker and the amount of money shown on the tile. If there are victory points printed by the name of the tile, gain those immediately. Then place the tile in your park next to another tile. The actions and other effects on the tile can be activated in a later phase. Refill the board by sliding necessary tiles down and then adding a new tile in the first space. On the attractions island, you can choose one of the four attractions to build. You pay the cost shown on the tile and then place it in your park next to another tile. You do not need to spend a worker to build these tiles. You can never have more than one tile with the same name in your park, so you can only ever build one of each of the four attraction tiles. On the Dino Paddock Island, there are two actions you can choose. To build a Dino Paddock tile, spend one green worker, or any two workers, and pay the cost on the tile. Then place the tile in your park next to another tile, but not another paddock tile. In a later phase, you can create dinosaurs to place in the paddock. Refill the board by sliding necessary tiles down, and then adding a new tile in the first space. To gather DNA, spend 1 to 3 workers of any colors and select a single DNA die. Gain all the DNA icons shown on the die, multiplied by the number of workers spent. Move your resource markers on the DNA tracks to show what you gained. If you use any scientists, blue workers, for this action, you also gain one DNA type of your choice for each blue worker you used. Then return the die to the bag. Don't use all your workers in this phase. You'll need some for the next phases too. When you're finished taking public actions, you can pass. But once you pass, you can never join back in. Once everyone has passed, then you move to the next phase. In the private actions phase, you'll be taking actions on your park board. None of these actions affect other players, so you can do this phase simultaneously. You can take the actions in any order up to 3 times each. You just have to be able to spend the workers and pay any costs. The DNA refinement action lets you combine basic DNA into an advanced DNA or split an advanced DNA into 2 basic, according to the printed recipes. For each worker, you can perform 1 transaction, either a combination or a split. When you use a scientist, a blue worker, you also gain 1 basic DNA of your choice. The VC funding action gives you money equal to the space you place your worker on. If you use an administrator, a green worker, you gain an extra coin. The security action lets you advance your marker on the security track 1 space. You must pay the cost associated with the space you move to. Each space in this zone costs 2 coins. If you use a security worker, a yellow worker, the cost is reduced by 1. If you go above 10 or 20 on the security track, place the excess security marker on your board. The Jeep Garage action lets you advance your marker on the Jeep upgrade track 1 space. You must pay the cost associated with the space you move to. Each space in this zone costs 3 coins. If you use a park ranger, the purple worker, the cost is reduced by 1 coin. If you reach a new zone, choose an available Jeep bonus, place it in the bonus slot, and immediately gain the reward. The Make Dinosaurs action lets you place a dinosaur in your park. When placing a dinosaur in a paddock, you must put it in the leftmost empty space. Spend the DNA shown at the top of the tile in any shown in the space you're placing the dinosaur. Then place the appropriately colored dinosaur and immediately gain the victory points and the amount of threat shown in the space. If you go above 10 or 20 on the threat track, place the excess threat marker on your board. Some special building tiles also have spots for dinosaurs. Use the Make a Dinosaur action and spend the DNA shown on the space. Managing your threat and security level is important. At the end of the round, if you have more threat than security, you're gonna be in big trouble. During the phases, players may achieve some of the objectives. When a player meets the requirements of a card, they place their token on it and gain the points. Once everyone has finished taking their private actions, it's time to move to the next phase. In the Jeep Tour phase, you'll be moving your Jeeple to different tiles in your park and activating them. None of these actions affect other players, so you can play this simultaneously. Your Jeep upgrade track shows how many tiles you can move to. Your Jeep starts on the Welcome Center. For each movement, it can travel to an adjacent tile, but the Jeep can never move onto the same tile more than once during a round. When your Jeep enters a tile, you can choose to activate it. For special buildings and attractions, spend the required workers and pay any costs. Then you gain, or lose, excitement based on the amount printed on the tile minus the value of the boredom token. The first time you visit, there won't be a boredom token. Next, increase the boredom. The first time you visit, place a boredom token with value 1 showing. For this prototype, we're using dice. On later visits, increase the value of the token from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and so on. Then you take the action on the tile. The rulebook describes all of the tiles and their actions. Many of them give you ways to gain coins, points, or DNA. For Dino Paddocks, you first gain, or lose, excitement based on how many dinosaurs are in the paddock. So these two generate 4 excitement, minus the value of the boredom token. Next, you increase the boredom. Then you roll the dino attack die that matches the dinosaur type, herbivore, small carnivore, or large carnivore. You roll the die once, no matter how many dinos are in the paddock. If you roll this symbol, gain 1 death token for each icon. You can move through tiles without activating them, but they still use one of your movement points. Once everyone is finished with their Jeep tour, it's time to move to the final phase in the round. During the income and cleanup phase, players will gain coins and bonuses and prepare the boards for the next round. Players take these steps: return their Jeeple to their Welcome Center, gain the benefits from all of their Jeep tokens slotted on their board, collect coins based on their level on the excitement track, reset their excitement back to 0, and return any used workers from their park to the supply. If you have any workers that you didn't use during the round, you can keep them for the next round. Now players check their threat level. If you have more threat than your security level, you gain 1 death token for each security level you're missing. To prepare the Central Island boards, return all DNA dice to the bag. Discard 2 dinosaur paddock tiles from the end of the track, slide the remaining tile forward, and reveal new tiles to fill the empty spaces. Discard 2 special building tiles from the end of the track, 3 tiles if you're playing with 2 players, slide the remaining tiles forward and reveal new tiles to fill the empty spaces. On the public notice board, adjust turn order based on fewest to most victory points. If there is a tie, the tie player who is later in turn order moves ahead. Finally, advance the round marker. At the end of round 3, you pick up your Welcome Center tile, flip it to the park entrance side, and place it somewhere else in your park. Your Jeeple moves with the tile. After you complete your 5th round, the game is over and it's time for final scoring. There are only 2 things left to score at the end of the game: your coins and your death tokens. You score 1 point for every 5 coins. For the death tokens, there's a little bit of a process. First, you determine who has the fewest tokens. That player discards all of their tokens. Then, every other player discards the same number of tokens as the player who had the fewest. Finally, players count their remaining death tokens and lose points based on the scale in the rulebook. The more tokens you have, the higher the penalty. Whoever has the most points wins. If there's a tie, the tied player with the most DNA remaining wins. So now you're ready to open your own dinosaur world.